Hey, 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 Life Uncloseted family. Happy, happy, happy new year. Here we are, the first Friday of January 2019. I hope you all had a wonderful holiday season, a great New Year's, and that whatever's been happening since January 1 is working out for you really good, whether that's recovering from hangovers, setting some, well, I don't like setting resolutions. We're going to talk about that today, but whatever's going on, I hope it's really great for you. In fact, I'd love to talk about a great way to step into the new year. Now, we can talk about goals, we can talk about resolutions, and what I'm going to propose to you is just a slight twist on this, but I find that if we get too set on resolutions, they never happen. I find that goals are great because we want to see where we're going, but sometimes we can set these resolutions and these goals and then nothing, absolutely nothing happens. For myself, what I've found has worked really good is what I call the IARs. Okay, so it's a silly little acronym, but what it is 12 months of intentions. And once I set those intentions, then I build actions to achieve those intentions. And I also identify when that intention and those actions have been taken, and a certain result that I want to achieve, how does that result make me feel? What is it that I got to experience? And I know many of you have listened to this podcast before, and you know that I'm always about what is it you want to feel? What is it you want to experience? And we're going there again in 2019. So here's how we do this. You set an intention for each month. And then based on that intention, I want you to write 1 to 3 action steps you're going to take to bring that intention alive so that it produces a result. So there they are, the intention, the action, and the result. Now, because I feel like I'm the guy who needs to eat his own dog food, today I'm going to share with you my 12 months of intentions. Now, what I do for mine, now you can do this however you want, I pick an intention for each month. But before we go into that, I want to share where this really starts for me, which is a friend of mine, Chris Brogan. Great guy. Check him out, chrisbrogan.com. I'm actually going to put a link to his 3 words article, video, etc. here. And I'm going to try, one of my intentions is to try to quit saying I'm going to put those links in because this 3-word exercise is what got me going. And then I started to use the 3 words to develop my 12 IARs. So my 3 words for this year are you ready for them? Audacious, spontaneous, and are you ready for it? Audacious, spontaneous, and trust. Now, spontaneous and trust I'm playing with a little bit because I'm not sure I like those, but we're going to go with those for right now because each of those words is going to guide me through my IARs. So with audaciousness, being bold, spontaneous, taking some risks, doing some things on the fly, and then trusting that it's all going to work out. Each of those things ties to these IARs. So here's number one, my first IAR for January. And I'm not going to tell you month by month, but I'm going to say this is the one I'm definitely starting with, is less judgment. Less judgment towards myself, less judgment towards others. Number two, I'm going to practice thinking before I react. I tend to react, and I don't like it because it always gets me in hot water. I hate it. So I'm going to practice thinking before I react. The third one is a friend of mine, Mike Ganina, who's been on this podcast a couple of times. He is the master of improv, and improv involves what they call yes and. You say yes to something, and we don't just stop there. So I'm going to practice a lot more yes ands in my life this year. Next one is I'm going to say no more often. I tend to be a yes guy. Not a yes and guy, but I'm working on the yes ands. I'm going to start to say no. I've already said no to some things. In fact, I'll give you some good examples. I have said no to attending a couple of conferences that I usually go attend. Doesn't mean I'm not 100% sure I won't end up there, but for now, I have not booked the advance tickets that were on sale, where I got a huge discount, which was a huge thing for me. I said no to both of these conferences because I'm making room for some personal growth in other areas. The next one I'm going to do, which is another I, is I'm going to let patience rule. Sometimes I get very impatient, so I'm going to practice patience and make it a rule for myself. I'm going to be, and I want you to listen to this one really closely, I'm going to be more interested, not interesting, interested. I know this from networking and stuff, and a good friend of mine taught me this one, but I don't practice it enough, and this year I want to make it a practice, is I want to be more interested, whether it's interested in other people, more interested in what I can learn, more interested in just listening. I want to practice being more interested. I also want to cut loose. Yes, I want to have some fun. That's why spontaneous is one of my words. I know when I have more fun and I'm spontaneous and I cut loose, things are much better, which leads to the next one. I want to laugh more. I want to have fun. I want to laugh at myself. I want to be more jovial. I've got a Santa belly, so why not use it? But that Santa belly is going away too. So yes, cut loose and laugh more. Those are two of the ones. And when I do that, I move right to my next one, which is to be more me. And now I'm pretty much me, but there are times that I pull back because I think, oh, this is what I'm supposed to do, blah, 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 blah. And I want to step more into being more me. I kind of lose sight of that at times. And in order to do that, my next one is I want to heal my shit. Yes, heal, like fix it. I want to heal my shit before I tell others how to heal theirs. I'm pretty good at listening and helping guide people, but sometimes when those close to me, I realize, man, they got some stuff they got to go fix. I get focused on them fixing, and then I forget to go look at why is that trigger happening. So I'm putting an intention out there to heal my shit before I tell others to go heal theirs. And then there's this lovely little obliger in myself that I want. I want to let that person still be there, that little lovely characteristic of obliging and doing things for others. But I don't want obligation to lead me to being hurt. Sometimes I oblige and go do stuff and then I end up getting hurt because I feel overstressed, overworked, not appreciated, doing stuff for others. They're not doing stuff for me. So I'm going to work on not doing stuff out of obligation that might cause me to feel hurt. And the final I for me is I'm going to quit second guessing, or I'm going to work on it, but I'm not going to accomplish that all the way, but I want to work on quitting second guessing myself, others, making assumptions, all that sort of stuff. So it kind of falls into that. So really quickly, I'm going to run through them once again, my IARs, and I'm working on the action steps and then I'm working on the results. This is something I'm doing for myself this week. I'm not going to share all that with you, but here's my 12: less judgment, think before I react, practicing yes and, saying more no's, I'm letting patience rule, I want to be more interested, I want to cut loose, I'm going to laugh more, I'm going to be more me, I'm going to allow myself to heal my shit before I hold others responsible for healing theirs, and I don't want to let obligations lead me to being hurt. And finally, I want to quit second guessing. So what do I want you to take from this conversation? I want you to go check out my buddy Chris Brogan's blog about his three words, how he comes up with them. I think it'll be really helpful. My three words again are audacious, spontaneous, and trusting. And then do your IARs. And remember, the I is your intention. What do you intend to do? You don't have to do 12, but maybe you pick 3 intentions for the year. Maybe you pick 6. I don't care how you want to do it, but I'm just suggesting this is what you might want to do. And then for each intention, come up with 3 action steps that will help you get there. And then look at the results. When that result has been achieved, what do you want to feel and what do you want to experience? So that's it. That's it. We're at the end of the first, well, not full week of the year, but pretty dang close. I'm so glad to have you here. Stay tuned because there's going to be some changes coming up. We're going to be shifting some things with Life Uncloseted. It'll still be here, so don't freak out. But this time slot that we're talking here on Fridays, well, there's something new coming. So anyway, have a great rest of your week. Enjoy your weekend. And we will be back next week with a really, really cool episode of Life Uncloseted. We're going to be talking about, I think next week we're talking about being yourself in the workplace. And then the week after that, we're going to talk about a friend of mine who took the risks to really step up and go do the things she wanted to do with her career. So there's a couple of great episodes coming up. Stay tuned, have fun, and never stop stepping out, stepping up, and stepping into making your bold moves, living your life uncloseted, and living life on your terms. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.